morning, everybody. Johnny B. Good here, located in Gary, Indiana. Today is September 29th, 2014. Local time here is 5:13 a.m. Temperature is a muggy 58 degrees. I know one or several of you appreciate the night driving, so I thought I'd show you night driving. Well, early driving anyway, right? Anyway, when I got to the petrol last night, I didn't even get out of the truck. I stayed at that parking spot until this morning. I didn't go get fuel, I didn't get take shower, I didn't nothing. I felt very lazy, a very lazy Sunday anyway. So I woke up at about 4:30. Got my fuel, cast bands, got me a gallon of oil for Blue. I just got it, I didn't put it in. And I went. Made me regret that I didn't go all the way to Melrose Park last night, even though I still believe it's hard to find a place to park up there. I should have left earlier, avoid all this. A couple more minutes, this place will be jam-packed with traffic, right? All right, Tom is showing we are 43 miles to Melrose Park. And I think we're delivering to Jewel Osco, who is now Super Value. Oh, trust me, you don't want to deliver to Jewel or Super Value. They're not the nicest places to deliver. For one thing, they don't want you to sleep on their property. They don't really have a staging area. We are currently traveling on Interstate 80 and 94. 80 will continue on all the way to San Francisco, while 94 is going to bear to the right towards Chicago, all the way to Milwaukee, Wisconsin, all the way to Minneapolis, all the way to Montana, and I believe South Dakota or North Dakota. It's a long way up there. Now we're about a mile east of the Illinois state line. Welcome to Illinois, everyone. And good morning. Everybody likes to run around with their high beams on. This is going to be a very long video. We got like 40 miles to get there yet, so I don't know if you guys want to see the whole thing. This is 94. We have just now split from Interstate 80. Somebody's in a hurry. beautiful motorcycle lighting system. Five more miles to go. Dead. That's a lot of people. by the way, once again, a friendly reminder and a request for those of you who would care enough to send AJ a postcard. I don't know why I still haven't got around to looking up the address. But I would greatly appreciate if you guys could send AJ a postcard at her school. Her name is AJ Vollrath, V-O-L-L-R-A-T-H. Send it to Horseman Middle School. That school is located on Union Avenue in Sheboygan, Wisconsin. I'll try to look up the address on it a little later. Oh man. I should have left at 4 instead of 4:30. Well, I got up at 4:30. Well, no, I set my alarm at 4:30. On Google, the address for Horseman is by the way, Horseman is spelled H-O-R-A-C-E. Again, the name of that school is H-O-R-A-C-E. Second name is M-A-N-N, M-A-N-N, Horace Mann, two word, again it's H-O-R-A, C-E. Second word, second name is M-A-N-N. Horseman Middle School. And the address is 2820 Union Avenue, Sheboygan, Wisconsin. Sheboygan is spelled S-H-E-B-O-Y-G-A-N. And the zip code is 53081. Again, it's Horseman Middle School. Union Avenue, Sheboygan, Wisconsin. And tell her her dad needs medicine. She'll know what it means. Can you imagine doing this every night, every day, every morning? If you live here, this is your life. Stuck in traffic every single morning. But I suppose if you live here, this is normal. You don't even notice it. I wonder what we as individuals of different walks in life, I wonder what we don't notice about our life. I'm sure each and every one of us has a from the perspective of the outsider, there's got to be something wrong or, you know, less ideal that we just now accept. And it's so normal to our lives that we don't even notice it. think it's safe to say that we are now in Chicago, right? Yeah, we're definitely in Chicago. I'd like to say hello and greetings to my good friend Mara, who goes to school, to Fatima University in Camiguin Island. Mara, I hope you are enjoying your school at Fatima College. I hope everything is well. Your uncle JP would like to say hello to you. Good to be back home again. Yeah, I'm sure you can hear it. He's a gambler. He has these fancy clothes. They were to be. Continental, yeah, an El Dorado too. On his pocket full chain, on his shoes. Yeah, man, Leroy Brown, that is man in the whole goddamn. Got a hooking call, meaner than a junkyard dog. Nice. I hate this copyright infringement stuff. Hey Van, get back in your lane. This man in the whole damn. Matter than a whole cane cow. Meaner than a junkyard dog. Alright, we gotta get to 290 west. Man, this is just way too early for this. Yep, them four-wheelers are not gonna let me in. They're just gonna keep on piling. As if, I mean, seriously. People, it doesn't take much to give up a lane. It won't cost you anything. custom Continental. He's got an Eldorado too. Pick a lane there, buddy. Pick a lane. I'd prefer if you stay in your lane. Now trying to loop around this to 294, which I believe it's called the Eisenhower, I think. I don't know, I could never remember what the names are. Highways here. Now, I know there's the Kennedy and the Dan Ryan. I think the Kennedy and Dan Ryan is the 94. I don't know. But I do know that Interstate 55 is the Stevenson. I know that. Don't even bother trying to tell me. I've tried to remember that for the last 20 years. It never sinks in. At least the westbound side here is pretty clear. over there, the junkie over there. Tom wants us to go and head north on Harlem Avenue. Looked like a jigsaw puzzle. But a couple of pieces gone. You know, I just realized something. Here in Chicago, I mean, this is unlike New York. In Chicago, it's okay to have a car. It's not so hard to find places to park your car. It's not expensive to buy a car or own a car in Chicago. And they've got buses, trains. They've got, you know, it's a complete setup. And yet people still choose to drive and put up with all this traffic. There's just something about cars that people just really like to drive. In New York City, you're pretty much, you know, you're forced to take the subway or buses. I mean, it costs an arm and a leg to own a car in New York. Hey, did you guys know that one of the cheapest places to buy a used car, from what I heard, is Chicago? I don't know why that is, but supposedly if you want to buy a used car, buy it in Chicago. Something about used cars in Chicago that, in fact, from what I also heard vaguely, is that these people up north or wherever, you know, car dealerships and auctioneers, they go down to Chicago and buy these cars in volumes. Then they auction them off over there. By the way, the time here is 6:09 a.m. Back. You're welcome, driver. All right, we got to get off at this Harlem Avenue So let's do exactly that. Oh my, my, my. Still got 6 miles to go. Better take both lanes, otherwise we're not gonna make it. That worked out real well. Miles, and we gotta make a left on North Avenue, Illinois 64. wonder where Captain Kevin is this morning. Captain Kevin. Yeah, Captain Kevin should have been a pilot. He sure knows a lot about aircrafts. This is Chicago. They have what they call low bridges around here. Little street is available. You ever wonder how many of those wrong turns that we make in our lives? I mean, I bet you most of the wrong turns we make in our lives, you know, we do it by ourselves. But I wonder how many of those wrong turns that we are really actually supposed to take by a divine design. Sometimes maybe we are supposed to make a wrong turn because there's an accident up ahead and it's not your time yet, and it's without you making the wrong turn, the ordained wrong turn, you'd be in danger, or injured, or you'll end up seeing something you're not supposed to, or and since there's no proof either way, who can say that it doesn't exist? gonna find ourselves. I believe there's a Toys R Us. Toys R Us somewhere around here, and we gotta make a right on that light. Is it this one? Is it this one? No, not this one. I believe it's this one. Oh, not Toys R Us. Yeah, Toys R Us is over there. But my landmark has always been Radio Shack. Sign right there, no parking, idling, or no, blah 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 blah. And yeah, there are trucks here that park here at night. Well, just because there are trucks park here at night, I can't. Nope, stop sign. Why would there be a stop sign here? I can't sleep at night when there's a sign that says no parking, even though there's a gazillion trucks. Even though there's a gazillion trucks parked around it, and they don't really enforce it. I can't rest at night doing that. It's kind of weird. I hate the idea of waking up early in the morning when I wake up, or somebody's gonna wake me up and give me a, or those form that says, congratulations, you have contributed. All right, we'll catch you later. Sorry about the long video, but Johnny be good here. Have a good and godly day.